Here's the thing about being relentlessly strange. Sometimes it's just not gonna work. Mortdecai is Johnny Depp's latest, this time playing an eccentric art dealer caught up in a world of hoodlums, investigators, priceless art pieces, and his new mustache as he bumbles his way through trying to save his family's finances. It's certainly another odd and peculiar character portrayal by Depp. Not that that's a shock. In fact, I think at this point, we'd be more surprised if Depp decided to just play it straight. Of course, that's not to say he's awful in this. In fact, he does just fine. Depp's a pro, and there's certainly some moments in this that I bought into this strange Mr. Mortdecai. But there were just as many moments when I felt almost an air of desperation in the performance, as if he was trying to save the weak material around him with a twirl of his mustache and just couldn't quite pull it off. Even with some great support in the wings, Gwyneth Paltrow, Ethan Hawke, and Olivia Munn all do really good work here with what they're given. And it was absolutely wonderful to see Jeff Goldblum on the screen, who I'm desperately hoping sees some sort of film resurgence here soon. But the question remains, since this is a comedy, is it actually funny? And I guess my answer is, occasionally? I mean, there are a few distinct moments that the humor almost feels laser accurate with its wit, but unfortunately, I think the key word in that sentence is few. Most of this comes down to what feels like a real failure to nail down what kind of movie they're trying to make here. First, the tone feels completely inconsistent. Some of the time, this feels like a quirky Wes Anderson piece, and then seconds later, I'm wondering if Mike Myers is about to pop around the corner as Austin Powers. At some point, it needed to be able to settle into a feel for either a quirky art piece or a slapstick broad comedy, and it just felt indecisive and therefore disjointed as it wavered back and forth. I also couldn't really place it in time. There's something very 1980s about the style, and yet cell phones and other modern inventions are present as well. It's also an interesting choice to make this R-rated, especially as close to PG-13 as it feels, except for a few choice moments that could have easily been adapted. The end result is a movie that either subconsciously or even consciously never lets the audience really sink into it, and therefore it just feels strange, uncomfortable, weird, and even unfunny. Of course, many times, these are exactly the kind of movies that become cult hits down the line, so let's check back in about 10 years and see if people are throwing Mortdecai parties or dressing up with a quaint mustache for Halloween. My guess is not. Overall, Mortdecai is an unfortunate miss for Johnny Depp and his stellar cast. The movie's inconsistency and indecision results in a comedy that never quite feels funny enough to justify its strangeness and ends up walking away with a piece of art valued around a C-. Thanks for checking out this Your Movie Friend review. Stay tuned for this review's best ever challenge here in a bit. First, I want to throw some stuff up over here that you can click on. If you'd like to subscribe, which I'd very much appreciate, do that by clicking the big gray subscribe button. If you want to see more, well, The Boy Next Door is also out this week, so you can check that out. I should also have reviews of Strange Magic and Cake at yourmoviefriend.com, which you can go to by clicking the logo right up here. That's also where you can find a searchable database of reviews, as well as the written text of some of these videos. And finally, this review's best ever challenge, where you name the best ever in a particular category and also try to identify my choice. Let's go with, what's the most quirky Johnny Depp performance ever? Mine has to be the one where he was wilder than ever. Drop your own answer and a guess at mine in the comments, and the first person to guess mine does get a point. Thanks, and please subscribe.